Welcome back. As promised, let's get that conversation going with Gautam Duggad of Motilal Oswal. Gautam, good morning. Thank you for joining us on the show. So we are in very interesting times and tough times, really, specifically for the mid-cap market, considering how this sort of crisis of confidence or the trust deficit has really built up. So the question is this, I mean, are you expecting 2019 to be an absolute washout year for mid-caps? So should we sort of write off the hopes of a recovery in this calendar year? Or do you think there's some light at the end of the tunnel?
It's already been a very tough last 18 months for the mid-caps. So if you look at the mid-cap index, it is still, I think, 15-16% below the December 17 levels. I am talking about the Nifty Mid-Cap 100. And more importantly, as we've been highlighting, the polarization in the market just keeps, getting more and more entrenched, be it Nifty or be it Nifty Mid-Cap. In fact, if you look at Nifty top 15 stocks, they are up around 11-odd% in the last 15-odd months or 18-odd months if you replot the index using just 15 Nifty stocks, and the rest 35 are down. Same is the case for Nifty Mid-Cap. Again, if you take the top 15 stock of Nifty Mid-Cap 100, they are up, I think, 8%. Whereas the bottom, specifically, but the rest 85 are down around 21-odd%. So essentially, it's a case of a market which is grappling with two big underlying things. One is the economic slowdown. More importantly, on the consumption side, because the investment has always been very patchy, led more by public investment. And secondly, whatever earnings growth that we have seen has been very, very narrow. In fact, if you look at FY20 expectations also, 70% of our incremental Nifty earnings for FY20 is expected to come from BFSI. So what is that telling you? That is telling you that ex of BFSI, there's hardly any earnings recovery. And with more and more evidences of slowdown getting out, I think there is more downside risk for the earnings estimate for FY20. Compared to what we were thinking 3 months back or 6 months back. So in this sort of an environment, the natural tendency is obviously to flock towards quality, and that's what we witnessed, be it in mid-caps or be it in the large caps. And I think that will continue till we get more evidence of some sort of a recovery. I think there are more headwinds actually. Monsoon has not seen any progress so far. And on top of that, the evidences of rural consumption slowdown is there. Auto numbers haven't improved. So it's going to be a bit of a tough grind for the market for the next couple of months.
Okay, by the way, just look at Mindtree, and you know why it's important is that we know that there's that open offer which is on, and Nalanda Capital has exited. Now, today's chart on Mindtree, and also we'll pull out the June futures and July futures. Now, that stock is under some selling pressure. And the June futures now trading at 20-point discount. So, heavy shorting now happening on that stock. That open offer was keeping the price at around 980. Also, if you see the July futures, which is very interesting, perhaps telling you about the hedging going on. And also, post that open offer, is that the fair price? 879 on July futures. So, a 68-point discount, which is opened up as far as July futures are concerned on Mindtree. So just keep that stock on your radar. It's really fascinating the way this one's moving in cash, in June futures, and in July futures. Gautam, hi, good morning. Your thoughts on IT and your thoughts on Mindtree itself?
Anuj, specific to Mindtree, I think as you pointed out, there will be volatility. This whole open offer event is out of the way, and depending on the news flow, how things pan out. As far as fundamentals are concerned, on IT, we are quite sanguine about it, given the fortunes of other sectors in the market. And IT comes out as a very strong defense right now, given that consumer is a very expensive sector, and pharma, there is no earnings growth. Plus, there are so many headwinds in the pharma. So, IT remains the sole defense pack right now with a reasonable valuation. Within that, our preference is more towards tier 1, names like Infosys, names like Tech Mahindra. I think IT will give you 8-10% growth. Plus, you have a decent capital returns which is going on, be it through dividend or share buybacks. So, IT sits in well in a portfolio as a defensive pack, and we are positive on IT.
Okay, positive on IT. By the way, Z Entertainment is now down over 2.5%. So big volumes piling up over there on that increased disclosures that, you know, Z Entertainment had to do. They had uploaded related party disclosures on the exchanges, and there have been some really disconcerting facts coming through. Gautam, hi, good morning. I wanted your thoughts on Emami. You know, on one hand, of course, promoters are selling their assets to repay debt, etc. But should that really be a big concern for long-term investors, or would you keep the faith here, considering that at some point when the economy picks up, you know, Emami would be a big beneficiary there?
I tend to agree with the latter part of your statement. I think it's a consumer business. Within Emami, you don't have too much of debt. But what has happened with Emami's FMCG business in the last 3 years, it has gone into a spiral of a slowdown led by so many factors, you know. And plus the portfolio is so climate driven, you know, summer portfolio, winter portfolio. And last 2-3 years, we have seen disruptions in the climatic conditions also. Plus the fact that they have a heavy dependence on wholesale, which has had a set of challenges post the demonetization as well as GST. So they've gone through a lot of rough weather. Even now as we speak, I don't think this quarter is going to see any material improvement. Stock has corrected, obviously. Stock is now at somewhere around 21, 22 times. But I don't see any change in fortunes in a hurry. That will be a function of how you know, the underlying FMCG business shows earnings recovery, and that would be the case for a lot of other FMCG companies as well, barring maybe Lever and Titan, which are in their own different world right now. But broader FMCG space has gone through a consumption slowdown in the last quarter, and I think this quarter's numbers will also be a bit somber.
Mm-hmm. So Gautam, what are your top mid-cap buys right now? That's sort of a tough area to get it. You need to make sure that there's no leverage at the company level, promoter level, books are clean, you know, there's reasonable growth. What are the top stocks on your list?
Yeah, so what we like in mid-cap, again, mid-cap is a very bottoms-up space, so there is no sectoral bias, so to say. But again, our preferences are more driven towards financials, bit of consumption, and then some bit of discretionary lifestyle related stocks. So what we like in financials is Federal Bank, AU Bank and RBL. In consumption, we like ABFRL, we like Trent, Indian Hotels. Then in the agri space, we like Godrej Agrovet there. And in the real estate, we have preference towards Oberoi as well as Brigade. And then in IT, our preference has been towards Sensar of late. So those are a bit of, you know, a mix of stocks from across sectors in the mid-cap. But as I said in the beginning, for mid-caps to perform, you need to have far better sentiments, both from a market point of view as well as from an economy point of view, wherein liquidity crisis has not yet got over as far as NBFC is concerned. And that is spilling over into the real economy in the last 3-4 months. So a lot of hopes are pinned onto budget, but I don't know how much it can assuage the sentiment. For me, more important is the Jalan committee report and whether it gives any room for the government to pump prime the economy, or you know, basically provide some fiscal stimulus. That is where a lot of hopes are settling in, and mid-caps will obviously be a function of how the sentiment revives.
Okay, by the way, just keep an eye on Yes Bank. There's some aggressive selling happening on that stock once again. After opening a bit higher, that one's moving towards the low point, and just seeing the build up in the futures, there's aggressive selling here. Gautam, any thoughts of sort of bargain buying here in Yes Bank, or is this a stock that you would want to give wide berth right now?
Anuj, I would wait for the clarity to emerge on the capital raise, because that is very important. They have the lowest tier 1 capital right now. Within banking, as we've been discussing in the past, our preference is more towards SBI, ICICI, Axis on the corporate side, and HDFC Bank on the retail side in the large cap. As I said, incrementally in the last couple of weeks, you have seen some uncertainty emerge on certain stress accounts. And then we have not seen much progress on the NCLT accounts for the big cases like SR or Bhushan Steel and Power. So maybe the expected recovery in profits of banking for FY20 may have been pushed back already from 1H to 2H. But all said and done, within the BFSI space, private financials is the only island which is looking relatively benign at the moment. And even now, one would pin hopes on some of these private corporate banks to deliver the incremental earnings for Nifty, as it is, as I said, 70% of incremental earnings are expected to come from banks. So within large caps, we continue to still prefer SBI, ICICI and Axis.
Okay, Gautam, thank you for talking about a range of stocks with us and appreciate your time. Well, that's the word coming in on a whole host of stocks. The market is still very quiet. The